Hello, welcome to Great Teaching Monk Program. In this video, you will learn about the five hindrances and how to overcome them. I am sure, whether you are new to meditations or practice regularly every day, whenever you meditate, each of us, most of the time, must face this kind of hindrance. Before I begin, let's take a look at the original state of the mind. The original state of the mind is very bright, clear, and pristine. But as the time goes when we grow up, we begin to learn, experience new things in our life, thus causing our mind to be changed over time. And so, it's not clear and pristine anymore. And to get back to its original state, it wasn't easy like we think. Because our mind are covered with these hindrances, which are sensual pleasure, angry mind, depressed mind, wandering mind, and doubtful mind. These are the obstacles. Whenever we meditate, we must facing them. And so let's take a look one by one. What are they and how to overcome them? The first one is sensual pleasure. Is the state of the mind that is clouded because of the pleasure through the five senses, which are seeing, hearing, smelling, tasting, and touching. These five senses are what clouded our mind. It could be compared to a glass of clear water filled with color until it lost its clarity. So in order to overcome them, first of all, when you meditate, you should pay no attention to these thoughts, whatever come through our mind. Do not continue your thoughts or try to think over the pleasure that the mind attached to. Or you could be carefully reason over the five senses that's coming into you. They are not real. They're just the record of the sensual pleasure that the mind attached of the past. The pleasant is you are sitting now. How can you feel? How can you experience them? It's just the thoughts. Or, compared to the impermanence of life or your own body, nothing in this world is permanent. Why should you wrinkle or attach your mind into these kind of thoughts or feelings? Now, when our mind attaches to something and we cannot get what we want, we become unsatisfied over this kind of feeling, thus leading to the angry mind. It is a state of a clouded mind that is darkened because of anger, hatred, or dissatisfaction. It could be compared like a clear boiling water that is unable to see through clearly. So in order to remove the angry mind, first of all, be natural. Letting go of everything that's come to your mind that make you angry. The reason to yourself is all in the past. You cannot fix. What can you do? Or you could spread loving kindness. Before you can spread loving kindness to others, you must be kind to yourself. Be kind to your own mind. So that way you can be kind to others. Or carefully reason over the cause of hatred, anger, and dissatisfaction. If you can be reason to yourself, you will find a way to let go of these thoughts. But this requires practice though. It doesn't come and work right away. When we are angry for a long time, sometimes it could lead us to depress. So does this leading to depressing mind or depressed mind? It is a state of uneasy mind that is restless, depressed, sleepy, not joyful, and unpleasant. It is much like a clear water covered by moss, duckweed, which is impossible to see what is inside. So, to remove these hindrances, first of all, when you meditate, use the bright object to keep your mind awake and alert. And how to imagine this kind of object? I would recommend you to watch our previous video quick guide to meditation. If you're very, very sleepy all the time, not because of repressing, but could also have sleepy mind, well, try to put more effort into meditation. Don't be too much relaxed. It should be in the right balance. Too much relaxed might leading you to sleepy. Or if in that day you have a lot of good meal, good lunch, a good breakfast, a good dinner, and when you try to meditate, it causing you to be very sleepy. Thus, next time when you have another meal, eat less and exercise more. Because our body, when we have a full stomach, when we meditate, it causing the blood that circulate into our brain to come down to help digesting on the stomach. And such, not enough oxygen in the brain, making us sleepy. Or check yourself in your meditation room, whether you have enough ventilation inside the room. Sometimes if you don't have enough air inside the room where you meditate, you could also falling asleep too. So check this very truly. And next is the wandering mind, the state of unstable mind that is muddled, absent mind, annoyed, vexed, and unable to find stillness because it's been troubled by thoughts or restless earlier from the other hindrance, or might not be having enough sleep or enough rest. It could be compared like a clear water troubled by waves, impossible to see what is inside. So to remove the wandering mind, never follow your wandering thoughts. Just be still. If the thoughts come, let it go. Don't continue it. Let it end. Or you can use the mantra that you can watch in our quick guide meditation to calm your mind down, in order to help you be more focused, keep you from wandering. And if you have a lot of thoughts and able to control your own thoughts, I would suggest this technique. It's called setting zero. Setting zero is like starting over. When you meditate, if the thoughts come, open your eyes. In this process, it will cut, and thus it's breaking the process of thinking in the mind. And so when the mind tired, it would cause no more thoughts in your meditation. Last but not least, this is considered to be the most dangerous hindrance of all, doubtful mind. Doubtful mind is a state of unanswered mind that is full of questions, doubts, distrust, and ignorance. This could cause many people to quit meditation or getting bored with it. It could be compared like a clear water or whirlpool, impossible to see what is inside. And so to overcome these hindrances, we must be patient and practice more and more until there is no more doubt into our mind, in our meditation. Or if you ever practice on your own, don't know what to do, you can consult the teachers or experienced meditator who has more experience than you to give you guidance on how to overcome them. So that way you can find the right way to practice meditation. These are the five hindrances and how to overcome them. So good luck in your meditation. If you find this video useful, don't forget to subscribe and share. Thank you for watching Great Teaching Monk program. See you again next video.